I definitely also have to go see Word of Life. They have my new Bible, and I need to go get it. Because this one has, it's about time to retire. It's gotten a little used, but that's a good thing. Hallelujah to God. We do give God the glory for what he's doing in this season. Amen. Hallelujah to God. You're tuned in to Harvest Time Apostolic Church. We're located at 10022 South Broadway in the beautiful city of Los Angeles. Our order of service is Sunday morning, 11:30 is a call to worship. There is a Wednesday hour of power from 7 to 8. Amen. Each fourth Sunday of the month, there is a Sunday night surge where God just comes in here and there is a deliverance, oh God. If you missed the last one, amen, you don't want to miss next Sunday, the 28th, amen, at 5 p.m., amen, will be the Sunday night surge as we get together with some of our brother and sister churches, amen, in the area, amen, and we lift up, oh God, the name of the Lord, amen. This next Sunday is we're going to talk about the sons of Jacob, amen.
All right.
Hallelujah.
All right.
So if you need to hear something from the Lord, if you would like to hear what God has to say, meet us here, amen, next Sunday evening at 5 o'clock, amen. Maybe you have not repented of your sins, maybe you have not been baptized in the name of Jesus to identify that is death, burial, or resurrection. Maybe you have not received the gift of the Holy Ghost. Maybe there's a question in your mind where you would spend eternity should Jesus crack the sky right now. Amen. Well, give me a call, Bishop Roger Gaines. That toll-free number is 888-294-7708, extension number 1. Amen. If you need a ride, if you'd like to come out and worship with us, give me a call on that same number again. It's 888-294-7708, extension number 1. I know once you get it, you'll say it was good for me to have been here. Now, come on, somebody, just give God a quick praise. Hallelujah. We are streaming this service live right now over Facebook. Amen. So we give God a praise for that. Amen. Hallelujah. We're moving forward with the grace and the help of God. If you grab your swords and real quick turn to the book of Ephesians. Ephesians, the fifth chapter. The fifth chapter. In fact, I think I'm only going to read two verses there, 26 and 27. And then we're going to skip back to the book of Psalms, the 139th division. But we're going to start at Ephesians. Ephesians 5:26. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We give you a few moments. Amen, hallelujah. And we're just excited about this season and what God is doing. And sometimes I heard a preacher say once that oftentimes we get happy about being on the brink of your promise to that you see the promise, but you get so close and you get excited about getting close that you give up in at the finish line. Well, I'm not giving up at the finish line. The finish line is in focus, amen. The Bible says we press towards the mark of the high call in Christ Jesus. And so since we see the finish line, amen, we're going to reach down. And as we used to say, amen, when we was running long distance and when you wanted to give up, the coach used to say it's time to grab your second wind. Amen. The coach used to tell us all the time, amen. I don't know if any of you ever had to do the 5-mile run, but around the third mile you're your body starts to switch up on you, and you start to feel the agony of running. And the coaches to tell us all the time, you only got 10 more miles. You done went through the hard part. You done made it through the first three. Why would you want to give up when you're so close to the finish? He used to tell us, it's time to reach down in your inner, oh God, your inner belly, and pull something out that you don't even know is there, and run this race like it's the last time you'll ever run, and finish strong. Amen. I can remember, amen, this one particular race, amen, and I was running, and I got down. I think I had one lap to go, and I don't know what it was about this one lap, but I just felt like I had about something that I hadn't used before, and I took off in a sprint, amen, and I ended up winning the race by, oh God, at least 10 or 15 yards. And the coach asked me, he said, why did you run like that in the beginning? You could have made this race a lot easier. Well, I said, I didn't even know I could finish like that. But when I looked down in my sights, something said, kick it into overdrive. It's not time. It is not time to give up. I got most folks to know I never liked finishing second. My God, I always wanted to finish on top. And so when I thought I was in, I did my fourth place. Hallelujah, God. And some said, just let it go. Give it all you got in God. If you're going to lose this race, make sure you give it everything that you have to finish it at your best. And so I reached down and I just ran as hard as I could.
Have fallen asleep at the spiritual wheel.
excited.
Hiya.
Because he's done so much for me. Let me get to the word. I'm trying to get y'all out of here. I need about 15 minutes. And we're going to go home. But I want y'all to know God is about to do something great. I got about 30 days. I just feel it in my spirit. This next 30 days, there's going to be something that's going to be so great that's about to happen. God bless you, First Lady. My God, there's something that's about to happen. I'm challenging God, but I'm holding God to his own word. Hallelujah, God, because he made me some promises. God has said some things. And since God said it, I believe it, and it's settled. But watch this, even if I don't believe it, it's still settled. But the fact that I believe it, pushes me closer to the manifestation of what I'm kicking the devil out of my household. He can't live there anymore. I'm kicking the devil out of the life of my children. You can't, oh God, you can't torment my kids any longer. I'm kicking the devil off of my job because you raised enough hell on my workplace to last me for the rest of my life. I'm serving the devil in eviction notice.
Yeah.
concerning. Somebody tell your neighbor, we taking the devil's kingdom down. We're destroying him. We're taking a fight to him. In the name of Jesus, I'm laying hands on myself. You can't live here. In the name of Jesus, God created me a clean heart and through the right spirit within me. I'm excited because God's about to do something new in this season. I've got Ephesians 5:26. I wish somebody would just get excited for the Lord. Each one of y'all got about 10 people you know that need to be in church. You need to get on the phone this week and encourage them to come out. Something is about to happen. 30 days, Lord. 30 days, Lord. I prophesy to my own, oh my God, to my own life, to my own existence, to my own family. Turn around. 30 days, Lord. This next 30 days is gonna be exciting. This next 30 days is gonna be glorious. This next 30 days, I'm gonna see power that I never seen before. And I'm gonna return all the glory back to you. I don't know how I got there, but that was for somebody. Somebody watching this live on Facebook right now. And I dare you to start to prophesy to your own life and begin to tell the devil, you got to get out of my house. You can't live here anymore. He didn't pay for the house. He's not paying rent. I'm just a devil man like this. Stop letting the devil live in your mind and in your house. Rent free. And then you have the nerve of trying to get a wife. You're going to vacate your own house and you're the one paying the bills in it. I dare you to stand on the word of God and tell the devil, you got to go. Hurry up. Hallelujah. We got to get ready. I got to get out of here. There's a wedding going on. There's about to be a wedding. And I want to tell y'all something else. There's an even bigger wedding that's about to happen. Because Jesus is coming back for his bride. And if you haven't made your calling and election sure, if you have not put on your royal wedding dress, to be married to the groom, you need to get yourself right even right now. I prophesy to those who are under the sound of my voice, whether you're in this house or you're watching this over the internet, you will not be lost. In the name of Jesus, I speak a turnaround. In the name of Jesus, Holy Ghost, have your way. Fill them up, Lord. Fill them up to the overflow, speaking with unknown tongues as the Spirit of God gives utterance. God, I want there to be an outpour of your Spirit in this season, in this time. I'm expecting somebody to call me and say, I don't know where I am, but God just healed me. Folks who are listening to this right now, you've been seeking the Holy Ghost for 10 and 15 years. Well, I'm speaking right now. Be healed, be saved, be delivered in the name of Jesus. Watch this, the 5th chapter, the 26th verse says, that he might sanctify and cleanse it with washing of water by the word. You can't run from the word. You need the word. Verse 27 says, that he might present it, it to himself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that, oh God, Bible says holiness without no man shall see God. God make us holy again. I got in the 139th division of the book of Psalms. Amen. Oh God, David writing here in verse number 1 says, O Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. Thou knowest my down sitting and my uprising. Oh God, thou, O God, understandeth my thoughts afar off. Thou compassest by my path and my lying down, and art acquainted with all my ways. Verse 4 says, for there is not a word of God in my tongue, but lo, O Lord, thou knowest it all together. Thou hast, O God, beset me behind and before, and laid thy hand upon me. Verse 6 says, such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high. It cannot attain unto you. I'm going to stop at verse 7. Whether I shall go from thy spirit, or whether I shall flee from thy presence. In other words, wherever I go, Lord, thou art there. Oh God, if you give me just a moment, just give me a moment, my topic on today, or my subject today, hallelujah to God, I'm God, I got my subject today, God, is Lord, remove every wrinkle, Lord, remove every wrinkle, I've got my subtopic or my sub-thought is, search me, O Lord, and if you find anything that shouldn't be, take it out, set me free, and the name of my God, of this text, or this talking to today is, I want to be right, I want to be saved, I want to be whole. Somebody ought to say, search me, Lord. Somebody come on, say, search me, Lord. Oh, God, I know, oh, God, normally, we set a God, or we do some searching either at the end of the year or at the beginning of the year. We either, oh God, look back on how we may have fallen or how we may have failed or what we may have accomplished in the past year. We tell ourselves how we won't make the same mistakes going into the new year. Or you get to the new year and set goals. Or you write down plans about things that you plan or you want to accomplish in this upcoming season. Now we've gone through the first month of the year, and somehow some of us have fallen off the plan already. Some of us have even thrown the plan out the window. Some of us have given up on God when we said, God, this is my year to serve you like never before. I'm so glad that God has a way of shaking you when you get off course. Well, God has a way of getting you back on course even when you get beside yourself. And that's why I say, search me, oh God. I'm God, and if you find anything that shouldn't be, check it out. Set me free. Because somehow, as I go through this journey on this life plan, the enemy keeps trying to knock on my door. Oh God, I gotta start letting the enemy know. How God, you've been evicted, and there is no vacancies. Stop trying to come back. Stop trying to make your residency here in my household. Stop thinking you can raise hell in my family. Stop thinking you can tear up my marriage. Stop thinking you can make my kids feelings, transgress against you. Stop thinking that I'm a dog in the town just because my bills may have gotten a little behind. But God said it like this: the cow on a thousand heels belongs to him. I gotta get enough courage that I take a God, a withdrawal out of the bank account of God. I put enough in here. And he said he would give me exceedingly and abundantly. He said he would give me an overflow. So if I already put into the bank, there's some interest that my deposit should have already collected. I'm so glad I'm going to be debt free. In fact, I am debt free. In the name of Jesus, I'm so glad that is stronger now than it's ever been. In the name of Jesus, I'm so glad that my family is stronger now. My children are all victorious. My children are all going to walk in the anointing of God. In the name of Jesus.
All right.
Yeah.
Yes.
But somehow, we allow ourselves to get off track. But God, the Bible says he's coming back for a church without spot or wrinkle. And in this chapter, he compares the church to a bride. Now, let me ask you a question. How many of y'all have ever gone to a wedding and a guy, they had the white carpet or the red carpet rolled down, and the flower girl came down and she threw the rose petals out, and everything looking so lovely, and the groom sitting there, and oh God, suited and booted in the finest tuxedo. I got it now. Here comes the bride walking into the church or the sanctuary, and as soon as she hits the runway, the first thing you notice is that her dress, oh God, is ripped on one side. It's all wrinkled, ugly, and dirty. Hallelujah, God, if you saw a bride like that, you would ask yourself, she must be crazy. This is supposed to be the biggest day of her life. You think she would have took the time to make sure everything was going to be perfect? Well, I'm so glad that when the bride of Christ, and even though we couldn't get all our wrinkles out, God had a way of putting us through a Holy Ghost, or God blessing, to get out the wrinkles. Hallelujah, God, and when there was a spot that was called sin on our garment, the Holy Ghost and the blood of Christ came through and wiped it away. I'm really trying to finish. But the one thing about blood.